What's up, everybody? Happy Tuesday. Welcome. My name is Ken. This is the Geeks Who Drink Tuesday Night Quiz. Happy Quiz Day, friends. Let's get at it. Round one, our first round. The theme for round one is Cosmos. And this round, as you may have seen teased in the email, is all about people named Cosmo. Yes, there are more than one. It's just straight up a round of people named Cosmo. So good luck. And yes, I'm drinking the Hialeah IPA again from Cigar City because it's my summer beer choice. Question number one. Here we go. Your first question in round one. Sir Cosmo Gordon Duff is one of the ritzier survivors of what 1912 North Atlantic tragedy? But yeah, let me know in chat what you're drinking. What is your drink of choice on that? I look older today. Well, that might be because I, in fact, got my first quarantine haircut today. Which is to say, my girlfriend cut my hair in the other room and made a hell of a mess of it. But I feel like it turned out okay. Oh, you're drinking Oberon, Leonosaurus. Now you're making me sad. Anyway, question number two. Question number two in round one, this whole round about people named Cosmo. Here is your second question. Cosmo Baker is a DJ based in what city that gave us The Roots, Independence Hall, and the murder of Hitchbot? We'll see how long it takes chat to get on this train. Thank you, everybody. For once, actually, there's like several people in chat saying something nice to me. That has almost never happened. It's kind of making me uncomfortable if you all want to, like, you know, scale it back and go back to that. It is weird. It is weird. All right, question number three. Let's keep it rolling. This round is round one. It's all about Cosmos, people named Cosmo. Here's your third question. Marvel's telepathic Cosmo the Space Dog is Soviet, just like what orbiting Sputnik 2 pupper? I hope at least somebody in chat appreciates the effort to make a Letterkenny reference in this question. I really do. All right, I really, you know what? That is an on-point insult, J. Cronus. You did it. You did it. That brought me down exactly to where I needed to be. Rip. Rip. Did you know that Letterkenny was named for me? Question number four. In round one, this round all about people named Cosmo. Here is your fourth question. More than a feeling, fact. Fran Cosmo succeeded Brad Delp as the lead singer of what Bay State band? And yeah, as you notice, we're rotating through our hosts. So for example, as much as I would have been absolutely hyped to host the Parks and Recreation theme quiz we're hosting this Thursday, you will not see my smiling face here. You'll see it in chat, because I will be absolutely playing that quiz. And yes, right here on Twitch, Parks and Rec, in 2 days. Question number five. In round number one, this round on Cosmo, here is question five. True or false? The Cosmopolitan cocktail is named for its inventor, bartender Cosmo Martini. Oh, y'all are having a good old time in chat. I've missed you, Twitch chat. I've missed you. And by missed you, I mean I've been moderating you the last couple weeks. So, you know, the incel and Nazi jokes is what I appreciate about you. Wrong kappa. Hold up. Geeks Who Drink Pub Quizzes. That is the wrong kappa. There you go. I'm just gonna one up you real quick. Don't mind me, chat. I'm just gonna one up you real quick. Question number six. Let's keep going in this round on Cosmo. We'll move right along. Round one, question number six. Don and Cosmo are best vaudeville bros in what Gene Kelly movie musical with a butt ton of umbrellas. That is an actual measurement, yes, butt ton. Scientifically, the number of umbrellas in this movie. I will not confirm nor deny the presence of mushrooms in this room or in my belly. Question number 7. Two more to go in our first round. Hope you're doing well in our round all about people named Cosmo. You know more than you think. Here's question 7. Sir Cosmo Bonzer's name was on a train line to what Thames spanning structure that makes Fergie say, "Oh shit." And I spent the entire day debating what I should call the Thames. And I decided that I would just call it the Thames. But I've been debating it all day. I've been sitting here in my room thinking, do I want to mispronounce Thames just to rile the chat up? I probably should. Thames the brakes? I don't get it, TS Master. Question number 8. Last question in this round. Yes, there is a bonus question. We'll have a giveaway, but let's get question number 8. Last question in this round. Here you go. George gets fired repeatedly by toxic sprocket King Cosmo Spacely on what old school futuristic cartoon? You got a couple minutes to finalize your round one answers. As always, we will have a conundrum box to give away with our bonus question, which is coming right up. The way that that works is you'll type an exclamation point and the correct answer into the chat spelled correctly. That'll get you an opportunity to win our bonus prize. Conundrum Box, making play from home escape room games. Exclamation point box in the chat. Any purchase you make with them does support Geeks Who Drink as well. So do consider that if you don't win one. Here is your bonus question. Get ready. Fingers ready, although speed absolutely has nothing to do with this. Here's your bonus question in round number 1. Fine. In a typical Seinfeld, Frank and Cosmo debate whether to call their male bra a manzier or what B word. Okay, let's see our answers in round 1. We got this ironed out. We'll get a winner picked. Round 1 answers. Let's see how you did. Let's see how you did on this round on Cosmos. Sir Gordon Duff is one of the richest survivors of the Titanic. Not that there were a lot of North Atlantic tragedies in the 1912. Number 2. Cosmo Baker is a DJ based in what city that murdered Hitchbot and gave us Gritty? It's Philadelphia. The one good thing about Philadelphia, that fucking mascot. Number 3. Marvel's telepathic Cosmo the Space Dog is a Soviet. Just like the pupper from Sputnik 2, that was Laika. Number 4. Friend Cosmo succeeded Brad Delp as the lead singer of Boston. I'm more than a feeling that some of you got that right. Number 5. The cosmopolitan cocktail is named for its inventor bartender Cosmo Martini. No, that's not a. That, I mean, somebody's probably named Cosmo Martini, but the inventor of the cosmopolitan, not him. Number 6. Don and Cosmo are best vaudeville bros in what Gene Kelly movie musical? That would be "Singing in the Rain." Just waste time songs. Number 7, Sir Cosmo Bonzer's name was on a train line to what Thames spanning structure? That would be the London Bridge. I can't sing that song because I honestly only heard bits of it. And number eight, George gets fired for repeatedly. Gets read by Cosmos Spacely on The Jetsons. The only old school futuristic cartoon. Well, there's others, but the most old school futuristic cartoon. Our bonus question. Yes, we will be giving one of these away. A conundrum box to a lucky winner in this round. The question again. In a typical Seinfeld, Frank and Cosmo debate whether to call their bra a manzier or whether or not it's a bro. What do you think, chat? Team bro, team manzier. I'm team manzier. I think bro is too short. It doesn't quite get it across. It really doesn't.
it fall off from the sky. Throw it up, throw it up. Watch it all fall out.
Selling female rapper for the record. Man, this is 65 million single soul. I ain't gotta compete with a single soul. I'm good with the ballpoint game, finger roll. Ask me how to do it, I don't tell a single soul. Pretty women, what's up? Is your hair right now? You a stand up or is you in your chair right now?
See how you did in this round where we decided these songs needed to be about poop. They very well could be. We're not sure. Here you are. Title and artist of each of these songs that you heard. Good luck. Number one. Oh, that visual, though. That's what's going to haunt your dreams. There it is. Nothing whiter than Whoops, There It Is by the Baja Men in chat, but it's actually by Tag Team. Number two.
In my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops.
That's Can't Stop the Feeling by Justin Timberlake. Every single one of these songs ruined for me. Question number three.
Oh, money on my mind, money on my mind. Throw it up, watch it fall off from the sky.
Pour It Up by Rihanna. That is not the direction poop is supposed to travel. Number four. When the Levee Breaks by Led Zeppelin. the visuals are something, aren't they? Question number five. They are something. Exactly, see, they are something. That's Truffle Butter by Nicki Minaj. Featuring Drake and Lil Wayne. Of course, you don't need those. You just need that Nicki Minaj for your point. Question number six. Baby, What a Big Surprise by Chicago. What a terrible surprise that would be. Number seven.
Then you better come in. It's just ability, that reason that we're so thin. Living and dying and the stories that are true. Sequel to a collapse.
It's Time Bomb by Rancid. And number eight, I know already that you all are going to be extremely mad about this, but you know we never said original, right? Because this is Landslide by the Dixie Chicks. That is what you're looking for the point. This is a song that I sung with my mom at karaoke on, like, at a birthday party one time. It's my mom's favorite song, and now all I can think about is how that song is, in fact, about sharding. Thanks. Jerks. All right, round three. Let's keep it going. Let's move right along. Round three. There's some instructions here you want to pay attention to. The man who mistook his wife for a hat. This round is worth 16 points. 16 points. It's a hit me round, if you remember how that works. If not, we're going to explain. Don't worry. Each question of this round will have two parts. You can answer the first part about wives for 1 point, or you can answer the second part about hats for 2 points. But you only answer once. So you answer the first half for 1 point or the second half for 2 points. It's an or, not an and. You'll get a point if the first one's correct. You'll get 2 points if you get the second one correct. And that's it. So only write down one answer. Good luck if you're playing along. If not, have a good old time doing whatever the fuck you care. Here's question number one. Round number three, question number one. For 1 point, Jennifer Lopez got engaged to what actor in 2002? I looked it up. That's how you pronounce that, right? Or for 2 points, that same year, she wore a wool cap and sang about her Bronx roots in the music video for what single? Again, you're only answering one of these questions. If you answer the first one, you'll get a point. If you answer the second one, you'll get 2 points. But that is the only thing you're doing. Only answer one of these questions. TS Master, I do have a hat. I mean, if you're insistent that I wear a hat for this round, we can make that happen. Hold up. Let me turn the lights on. So this round's about hats, right? So why don't we do this? Question number two. I have a hat for this. Here's question number two. For 1 point, Carmen Electra married Dennis Rodman near the end of his time with what three-peating NBA team? Or question number two, fruit hat enthusiast Carmen Miranda launched her showbiz career in what New World Nation? I mean, I really do feel like this hat is me. Like, if there's, I need to get my hair out of the way, but yeah, I feel like a proper cowboy. I feel like a proper cowboy. I wear hats. That's the difference between you and me, Eric. I wear the hat for my and the chat's enjoyment. You do things for money. That makes you a whore. Question number three. Taylor, I don't even have my headphones on and I can hear you laugh. Question number three. For 1 point, what main character marries Amy in the season 11 finale of The Big Bang Theory? Or question two, and this is a first and last name spelling question. You have to spell both right. Amy was played by what actress who was also the flowery hat wearing Blossom? So again, you gotta spell that second one right if you're answering it. We're judging you for that. We're judging you for that. Whoa, 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 Matt W. We never said I'm a whore or a working professional. You must be talking about somebody else. You're not wrong. Question number four. Let's keep this going. Again, you're answering only one of these questions for 1 or 2 points. Here's question number four. Holly Golightly has a creepy estranged husband in what author's Breakfast at Tiffany's? Or for 2 points, in the movie, she wears what oversized fashion piece that's French for morning hat? It is worth noting this hat does not actually fit on my head properly, so I have to sort of tilt it to make it actually work and fit in the frame. Never take the hat off. I don't know that I can wear the hat the whole time. I need my headphones at some point. Question number four. Let's keep going. I'm sorry, question number five. I can't even count. It's the beer talking. Here is number five. For 1 point, my wife, Isla Fisher, is married to what Borat guy? Or for 2 points, Isla wore a safari hat and saw Gal Gadot in her underwear for some reason in what dumb 2016 spy film? My mask is literally almost within arm reach. I can't quite get to my mask, but I do have it. It would just, sound pretty muffled. Everyone always wants to know what I'm drinking. It's always the same. Well, actually, it's not different. I'm drinking the High Lie IPA from Cigar City Brewing. They're a brewery in Tampa, I think, or they're in St. Pete. They're in one of those Florida towns. It's the one thing coming out of Florida right now that you actually might want. Question number six. For 1 point, Allison Weir wrote a best-selling book about the how many wives of Henry VIII. Or for 2 points, named for King George IV, Queen Elizabeth's go-to crown is what kind of D-word headpiece that's not the same as a tiara? Dolphins, I couldn't remember if they were from Tampa or St. Pete. They're basically the same. They're the same city, except for one of them is a shithole and the other is St. Pete. Look, I'm just going to take everything Chad says at 100% face value because that's all I can do. You haven't mastered the Kappa yet. It is just water. Yeah, I filled this with water before the quiz started. Question number seven. Round three, question number seven. For 1 point, Diego on My Mind is a trippy self and husband portrait by what artist? Or 2 points, what French fauvist painted his wife into his masterpiece, Woman with a Hat? I mean, I feel like I only said nice things about St. Pete, Troy. I actually like St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg is a beautiful town. I like St. Petersburg a lot. I said nice things about it. But Tampa, I have nothing nice to say. Question number eight, last question this round. Aside from the bonus question, yes, we will give away another conundrum box here at the end of the round, but your final question this round worth points here is question number eight. For 1 point, Jackie Onassis got that surname from her second husband, who shared what first name with a Greek philosopher? Or for 2 points, the day JFK was killed, she famously wore a pink suit and pillbox hat designed by what fashion house? I would like to say that my hat is an homage to that outfit, but that would be a lie. It's just conveniently the same color. All right, everybody, get your answers for round number three finalized if you're playing along, if you're playing from home. And let's do our bonus question. The way this works, again, our bonus question sponsored by Conundrum Box. We'll be giving one away. You can also purchase one from them directly, ! Box in the chat. We'll send you the link. All purchases support us. They make play from home escape rooms. Good luck. Here is your bonus question, ! And the correct answer in the chat. Here is your bonus question. Elder members of that grandma meetup group, the Red Hat Society, traditionally wear dresses of what color? For round number three, answers, let's go. Let's see how you did in round number three. I'll leave the hat on until the end of the answers, yeah? It just feels right. Jennifer Lopez got engaged to what actor in 2002? That would be Benjamin Affleck. I assume his name is Benjamin. 2 points, that same year she wore a wool cap and sang about her Bronx roots in Jenny from the Block. Number two, Carmen Electra married Dennis Rodman near the end of his time with what three-peating NBA team? That'd be the Chicago Bulls. And fruit hat enthusiast Carmen Miranda launched her career in Brazil. Number three, the main character that marries Amy in the season 11 finale of The Big Bang Theory is Sheldon Cooper specifically. And the actress that played Amy is Mayimbialik. That's how you spell it. M-A-Y-I-M-B-I-A-L-I-K. Make sure it's right. Question four. Polly Go Lightly as a creepy estranged husband in Breakfast at Tiffany's, written by Truman Capote. And 2 points in the movie. She wears an oversized fashion piece that's French for morning hat. That's Chapeau du Matin. I think I pronounced that right, but probably not. Question five. My wife, Isla Fisher, is married to what Borat guy? That would be Sasha Baron Cohen. And she wore a safari hat and saw Gal Gadot in her underwear for some reason in what dumb 2016 spy film? That is Keeping Up with the Joneses, which I'm sure all of you saw. Massive pop culture phenom. Number six, Alison Weir wrote a book. How many wives of Henry VIII? That would be the six wives. And 2 points. Queen Elizabeth's go-to crown is a diadem. Thank you, Diablo 2, for teaching me what that is. Question number seven. Diego on My Mind is a trippy self and husband portrait by what artist? That would be Frida Kahlo. And the French Fauvis that painted his wife into his masterpiece, Woman with a Hat, that's Henri Matisse. And number eight. Jackie Onassis got her surname from her second husband, real-life James Bond villain Aristotle Socrates Onassis. And 2 points, the day JFK was shot, she famously wore a pink suit and pillbox hat designed by Chanel. All right, your bonus question. Let's find ourselves a winner. Elder members of that grandma meetup group, the Red Hat Society, traditionally wear dresses of what color? Their dresses are purple. It breaks my heart, but for round four, we gotta take the hat off. It's time to get serious. Round four, good luck. Let's keep on rolling with our fourth round. The theme for round four tonight is Soylent Spring. Soylent Spring. It's a round on cannibalism and the slinky. Cannibalism and the slinky. They go hand in hand, coil and coil. Question number one, your first question this round. Here is question number one. Other mammals do it, but at least one Kardashian wrongly believes you can reduce postpartum depression by eating what temporary organ? I mean, I will probably say that at some point, chat will probably get me to put the hat back on. But we'll see. We'll see how I'm feeling. I would like to be able to hear Taylor's lovely voice, though, for a couple minutes, so. I know. I forgot that I had headphones around my neck. Question number two. In this round on slinkies and cannibalism. Here's question number two. If you fully stretch out a standard 6-ounce metal slinky, is it more or less than 50 feet? The unfortunate thing about the hat, the reason I'm not wearing it, is it does not fit over, it doesn't fit over my headphones. So the best I can do is leave it precariously, like, it's not a good look. It's not a good look. It's also gonna fall off my head and spill my beer. It was a great look without the headphones, just saying. Question number three. Again, the theme is Soylent Spring, around on cannibalism and the slinky. Here is question number three. A Redditor who lost his leg in a motorcycle accident, then served it to friends in the form of what traditional Tuesday fare? I hope chat has strong opinions about this question, as I do. Because these people are fucked. Question number four. In this round on cannibalism and the slinky, here's round four, question number four. Because it was invented and popularized there, every so often someone pushes to make Slinky the official toy of what Keystone State? Do states have official toys? Chat, someone in chat, let me know. You all are smarter than me. Do states have official toys, like in general, or is that just bullshit that these Slinky apologists are into? All right, question number 5. In this round on cannibalism and Slinkies, let's keep moving. Question number 5. We know Neanderthals ate each other under duress, but new evidence traces it to what relevant, again, worldwide phenomenon? I'm good to see that the answer is that states can have official whatever the fucks they want, and some of them have toys. Got it. Also, thank you, B. Weitzman. Thank you for the kind words, Brendan. I'll do my best to read the questions, but the upside is they're also on the screen. So if you're having some audio issues or if there is some audio issues, I highly recommend having the screen visible so you can read the questions there too. Question number 6. In this round on cannibalism and the Slinky, here is round 4, question number 6. The law of physics that explains Slinky's stair walking is named not for a J.M. Barrie captain, but physicist Robert Who. You know, I would not be at all surprised if Florida's official toy was in fact a dildo. I wouldn't be surprised. That sounds like a reasonable, smart choice for the state of Florida. All right, question number 7. 2 more to go in this round on cannibalism and the Slinky. Here is round 4, question number 7. The Toy Story inspired Slinky Dog Dash coaster is at what second tier Disney World park that doesn't intersect with Vine Street? We're gonna have to discuss the tiering of Disney parks after this, aren't we? We really are. It is second. I mean, I would argue it's third tier, but that's neither here nor there. I really do appreciate that chat has gone the extra mile. Thank you, Miss Amanda Joe, for actually doing the research and giving me all of the answers to the toy state toy question thing. All right, finally, question number 8, your last question in here. And don't you dare dismerch Epcot. I will come through that screen. Epcot is S tier. Question number 8, last question in the round. Goth Queen Tamora is served a pie made of her awful sons by the Venge title character of what gory Shakespeare play? I feel like you had to know this one was coming. This is the last question in round number 4. Yes, there is a bonus question. You'll have another opportunity to win a special prize from our friends at Conundrum Box. They make play at home escape rooms. Exclamation point. And the correct answer in the chat will get you entered for this drawing. Good luck. Here is your bonus question for a Conundrum Box. Betty James took over the Slinky biz after her ex, inventor Richard James, left to do Bible stuff in what landlocked South American country? Let's go. Let's keep it rolling. Round 4 answers. Here they come. Let's see how you did in round number four. Let's see how you did. Question number one. Other mammals do it, and at least one Kardashian wrongly believes you can reduce postpartum depression by eating the placenta. Not polenta. That's not the same thing. Question number two. If you fully stretch out a slinky, is it more or less than 50 feet long? It's more. It's about 65 feet. Video evidence on the screen for you. Question number three. A Redditor who lost his leg in a motorcycle accident then served it to his friends in the form of tacos. Also, all of those people should just... I wish that they would just be wiped from the planet. Question number four. Because it was invented and popularized there, every so often someone pushes to make Slinky the official toy of the Keystone State. That state is Pennsylvania. Of course, cilantro is the problem, Eric. Duh. Number five. We know Neanderthals ate each other under duress, but new evidence traces it to a what relevant, again, worldwide phenomenon? Climate change. Yes. Climate change. Made zombies of the Neanderthals, it did. Question number six. The law of physics that explains Slinky stairwalking is named for physicist Robert Hooke. Number seven. The Toy Story inspired Slinky Dog Dash Coasters at what second tier Disney World park? That would be Hollywood Studios, Disney's Hollywood Studios. I will call it MGM all I want, because that is the only name it deserves. Question number eight. Queen Tamora is served a pie made of her awful sons by the Venge title character in Titus Andronicus. Our bonus question. Let's give one of these away, yeah? Let's give one of these away. Who will win our third conundrum box of the night? Betty James took over the Slinky Biz after her ex and mentor Richard James left to do Bible stuff in what South American country? The landlocked South American country is Bolivia.
To do.
You're supposed to open that little door, and if you're brave enough, touch the beast inside.
Oh, is that all?
Supposed to open that little door, and if you're brave enough, touch the beast inside.
Oh, is that all?
He's the leader of the bunch. You know him well.
Genuinely pretty happy with the video game selection there, although that round could do with a little bit less Jonathan Blow, but you know, that's neither here nor there. Mostly just respect for fucking Peggle. Respect for Peggle. Round six, let's go. The theme for round six, a brief history of mime. which is around about underpants and silent performances. Good luck. Let's start. Question number one in round six is around on underpants and silent performances. Here is question number one. Instead of roll up your sleeves, the Japanese say tighten your fundoshi, the diaper-looking loincloth worn by athletes in what sport? Yeah, Curtis Blow and Jonathan Blow, not the same thing, have them. Not the same thing. One is genuinely an artist. Question number two. Question number two. Thank you. Don't use semicolons. You finished the joke for me. Elliot and Darlene hack Cyprus's national bank while keeping an angsty sibling silence for 45 minutes in a 2019 episode of what USA show? At this point, we should all be artists at washing their hands, Otters. I mean, what else have you had time to do but learn how to, in fact, wash your hands better than you did previous to this isolation? Yeah, just throwing that out there. Maybe practice. Spend a little time rubbing your hands together beneath the water. That's how you wash your hands, right? No other tools needed? Shit, I think I'm forgetting something. Question number three. In this round on underpants and silent performances, here is round six, question three. Glamour magazine went all the way back to an ancient Roman cloth called mimolare in their video about the history of what undergarment? Sometimes I generally don't know if chat is on a delay and they're answering the previous question or if they are just answering in whatever way they seem fit. Not sure, FaceTex. Not sure. Question number four. Let's keep it rolling in round six, around on underpants and silent performances. Here is round six, question four. Moshing in headphones is SOP at the silent disco, a running feature of what music festival whose name is basically Creole for Lollapalooza? I see you found a theme within the themes, chat. You found maybe a theme. The question is whether or not there'll be a third. There usually is. And Eric, way to upstage me from the chat. Question number five. Here is round six, question number five. At a 2007 anti-war rally, Sean Penn went on a hopefully metaphorical rant about what guy's soiled and blood-soaked underwear. So what you're telling me is it shouldn't be blood-soaked? I might need to see a doctor when this is all over. You can make that joke, Taylor. I'm not going to. No. All right, question number six. Round six, question number six. Prana Films declared bankruptcy to dodge lawsuits from Bram Stoker's widow, shortly after releasing what spooky silent films? Also, I'm now worried that the chat is offering to play doctor with me. I think that is content better suited to my OnlyFans page. Just as an aside. We'll throw a link in the chat later. DM me on Twitch for OnlyFans link. I don't know whose OnlyFans I'm going to send you to, but it won't be mine. Nobody would pay to see any of this. All right, question number 7. Two more to go in this round on mimes. Well, silent performances and underpants. Here is question number 7. For super cold weather, REI suggests wool underwear taken from what Spanish sheep that has never led the Dolphins to the Super Bowl? Will pay for a cowboy hat? I mean, that's a more reasonable ask. We could probably arrange something there. Taylor's trying to get me to bribe you subs for cowboy hat. I will not do that. I will not. But I will put the idea into the air and see what happens. Jerk. Taylor is trolling me from the production booth. How is this possible, Taylor? You monster. She is the ever-present force behind every bad idea. Brendan, you have to send me the Seattle Mariners cowboy hat. I do not own one of those because the Mariners would have to be good at some point for me to own memorabilia for them. Final question in the round. Question number 8. We have a bonus question, of course, as well, but here is the last question of the round. Listening to his own blood pump inside a freaky sound-canceling chamber inspired what composer to write a piece with no notes? I see what you're doing, Taylor. I see your. I literally see your screen. I literally can see your screen. I do have some Mariners memorabilia. I think from the 90s before I lived here. I was a Mariners fan before I moved here because Ken Griffey Jr.'s name is Ken, so I was a fan of Ken Griffey Jr. specifically. Because. I lived in Orlando. There weren't really options to be sports fans there. All right, bonus question time. Here we go. Again, sponsored by the Conundrum Box. They make play at home escape rooms. Exclamation point box in the chat if you want to pick one up. All proceeds, all purchases to them support Geeks Who Drink as well. So do check it out. Here's your bonus question. Exclamation point and the correct answer in the chat. If you're dying to hear Marcel Marceau's voice for some reason, he offers to repair Jane Fonda's ship in what 1960s sci-fi boobsploitation film? Let's go ahead and see how you did, though, in round 6, the round on silent performances and underwear. Good luck. Here are your answers. Number 1. Instead of roll up your sleeves, the Japanese say tighten your fundoshi, the diaper-looking loincloth worn by sumo wrestlers. Question number 2. Elliot and Darlene hack Cyprus's national bank while keeping angsty sibling silence for 45 minutes in a 2019 episode of Mr. Robot. The only reason anyone would ever watch the USA Network at this point. Question number 3. Glamour magazine went all the way back to an ancient Roman cloth called mammillare in their recent video about the history of the bra. Yeah, that's 2. Wait for the third. Question number 4. Moshing in headphones is SOP at the Silent Disco, a running feature of what music festival's name is basically Creole for Lollapalooza. That'd be Bonnaroo. It's at other music festivals too, but only one of them is Creole for Lollapalooza. Yeah? Yeah. Number five. At a 2007 anti-war rally, Sean Penn went on a hopefully metaphorical rant about soiled and blood-soaked underwear of George W. Bush. Ooh. Ooh. Number six. Prada Films declared bankruptcy to dodge lawsuits shortly after they released Nosferatu. Number seven. For super cold weather, I suggest wool underwear taken from what Spanish sheep that's never led the Dolphins to a Super Bowl? That's Merino. And yeah, I mean, I would grade to you harshly, but we didn't say spelling counts, so nah. Question number eight. Listening to his own blood pump inside a freaky noise-canceling chamber inspired what composer to write a piece with no notes? That'd be John Cage. It's just 4 minutes of silence. All right, your bonus question. If you're dying to hear Marcel Marceau's voice for some reason, he offers to repair Jane Fonda's ship in what 1960 sci-fi boobsploitation film? That movie is Barbarella.
Clad only in your undershorts.
Of course.
Even for you, I find that just a trifle casual.
Of course I am. Of course. What do you think I used to wipe off the bloody windscreen, the windshield, so I could drive the ruddy car?
Dad was right. The case doesn't add up.
Stay away from that case.
Does your dad still think that Lily's father did this?
Do you have any idea how dangerous it is what you're doing? That family will do anything to make that evidence go away.
Good. Take that as your cue to get to crackety cracking.
Oh. Am I dead?
I'm sorry, sister.
Are you kidding me?
You know, Sonny, seeing her again, well, it sort of opened up my eyes. I mean, I never drop her a line on her birthday or pick up the phone to call her at Christmas time. And but what I mean is that seeing her again just made me feel kind of...
guilty?
Don't be ridiculous. I claimed you on my taxi, Sean. Holy crap. Is this Bianca's pappardelle?
I found it in the kitchen fridge.
Oh my gosh, she's gonna go insane. She hand rolls her pasta every weekend, Sean. They take all day. She grinds her own spices, Sean.
Well, I thought it was for everybody.
Burton.
Bianca.
Cynical man thinking a woman like you would fall behind like that. It is malign. So please, hear me when I say this. I have never loved anyone as I do you right now, in this moment.
Spot on.
What do you think I used to wipe off the bloody windscreen, the windshield, so I could drive the ruddy car?
Dad was right. The case doesn't add up.
Stay away from that case.
Does your dad still think that Lily's father did this?
Oh. Am I dead?
I'm sorry, sister.
Are you kidding me?
Christmas time and... Well, what I mean is that seeing her again just made me feel kind of...
Guilty?
Pasta every weekend, Sean. They take all day. She grinds her own spices, Sean.
Well, I thought it was for everybody.
Burton.
Bianca.
I say this. I have never loved anyone as I do you right now, in this moment.
Spot on.
Hope you did all right in round number 7. We have one round to go. Round 8, our final round tonight. Wondering what the theme was? Well, what is life? But you know that the theme for round 8 is just random knowledge. Some questions will have multiple points. Some will be worth multiple points. We will let you know as we go. Good luck with our final round of the night. 16 points on the line. Here is question number 1. Round 8, question number 1 in random knowledge. Nitro and Zap were OG combatants in the 1989 debut of what sweaty TV competition? Yeah, I may not be the expert on the subject, but you probably have misunderstood the term daddy if I meet your definition of it. Just as an aside, you might want to revisit that. I don't need to know what I actually am. Although the hat does help. You're right. The hat does help. Question number 2 in this round on random knowledge. Here is question number 2. For 2 points, two inexorable points. Albania's flag features a red background and a gnarly double-headed eagle of what color? And for your second point, what's that Lewis Sacker young adult novel about Stanley Yelnats dragging up a bunch of shit? Or digging up a bunch of shit should be the actual answer. Oh boy, I definitely got the chat on some interesting topics. I'm gonna not look at the chat for a minute. I'm not gonna yuck your yum out loud. Internally, I'm gonna yuck some yums. Again, answer both of these, you'll get a point for each correct one. Let's keep it rolling. Question number three. I know you're very excited for round eight question number three, because of course it's an anagram. A famous equation for the mass energy equivalence debuted in the Annus Mirabilis papers by what physicist that anagrams do? Inane rebel tits. Yeah, I couldn't get away from just saying anus. I'm sorry. I've got anus on the mind. My apologies. Or you're welcome. Eric, you are also Twitch. You could clip that. You know that, right? I have a feeling the phrase, I've got anus on my mind, is going to come back to haunt me someday. Professionally, maybe. Personally, it's probably a boon. All right, question number four. Let's keep rolling in round number eight. Here's question number four. 3 points. Banoffee, chiffon, and mincemeat are varieties of what baked good? What's the MPAA rating for the 2020 film Bad Boys for Life? And lastly, a boxing ring is paradoxically called the what circle? And no, I have never played Fortnite. I don't really know what Fortnite is, other than it's a video game that people play. But I've never actually played it. Couldn't tell you anything about it. I do like fork knife now. Fork knife is good. It's an effective way to put food into your mouth. So I am for fork knife, but potentially not for Fortnite. Don't really know. I think it's a thing they do here on Twitch. All right, question number five. Let's keep going in round eight. This is round eight, question number five. Yes, Piggle is better than Fortnite, agreed. For his defensive prowess in the 2012 season, Cubs second baseman Darwin Barney took home what alliterative award handed out by Rawlings? I look forward to the argument we're going to have about this one. Because some of you are going to be upset when we tell you that you shouldn't get a point. All right, question number six. A couple more to go in our final round of night. Here's round eight, question number six. Three fill-in-the-blank points for you. That landmark 1998 Special Forces video game was Metal Gear Blank. The Newell brand competitor to Whiteout is Blank Paper. And the fart-reducing Simeticone is sold under the brand Blank X. 3 points for this question. Pegasus Fire. The problem is that the hat won't sit on my head properly. Like, it sort of does, but it's very, very tight. So, like, I could put it on like that, but you don't really get to see the full sparkle effect if I wear it like this. It fits better. But it doesn't quite show it off. Yes, I do remember. I remember the chemistry class I took in high school, but I didn't take any science classes in college because I didn't have to. All right, question number seven. Two more to go. Here is round eight, question number seven. Municipal and corporate are common types of what financial instrument that gives you a creditor stake in a company? Yeah, no, if you didn't know, what's happening with the hat is just what happens when I go outside in the sun. I just sparkle like one of those Twilight vampires. Do you not see how pale I am? This just comes from years of living in Seattle where the sun more or less never sees the horizon. We have one more question to go in round number 8. Well, we have two, because we have a bonus question, of course. One more conundrum box to give away. But here is question number 8, last question in the round. It is worth 4 points. For 4 points, I'll name a Billboard charting nerd tune. You give me the artist. Your first one is Radioactive in 2012. Your second is Starboy in 2016. Your third is The Scientist in 2002. And your last one is Neutron Dance in 1985. You're naming the artists of these songs. Also, sure, happy 30th birthday, Ben. I don't know if Ben is real or if it's truly Ben's 30th birthday, but you know what? Happy birthday, Ben. You lived to the 30. It's all downhill from there. Can confirm none of these songs are in fact made up. They might suck, but they're not made up. Again, we have one more conundrum box to give away. On our final bonus question of the night, Conundrum Box making escape rooms you can play from home. Check them out. Exclamation point box in the chat. Good luck. Exclamation point and the correct answer will get you what you need to be entered to win yourself a Conundrum Box. Here is your question. Your last bonus question of the night. A mammal in the Talpidae family, or just another name for an embedded spy. What name do they share? Yo, here we go. Let's see how you did. Round 8 answers. Good luck, friends. Let's see how you did. The hat didn't distract you too much. Nitro and Zap were OG combatants in the 1989 debut of American Gladiators. Whew, Nitro can get it. Number 2. Two inexorable points. Albania's flag was a red background and a gnarly double-headed black eagle. Thank you, The Simpsons. I know that answer. And the Lewis Sacker young adult novel about digging up a bunch of shit. It's called Holes. Number 3. The famous equation for mass energy equivalence debuted. I can't not see anus, but inane rebel tits would be Albert Einstein. Number 4. Banoffee, chiffon, and mincemeat are all varieties of pies. They're all pie. Now, your second one. The MPAA rating for the 2020 film Bad Boys for Life is R. I think you know where we're going with this. A boxing ring is paradoxically called the squared circle. You do need that ED, just as an aside. I'm being picky here. ED. Not just for old guys. For his defensive prowess in the 2020 season, Cubs baseman Darwin Barney got a gold glove. The golden gloves are given to boxers. If you put golden, you're wrong. I know it's plural, you're still wrong. Number 6. That landmark 98 video game was Metal Gear Solid. The Newell brand's competitor to Whiteout is liquid paper. And the fart-reducing drug Simeticone is sold as Gas-X. Number 7. Municipal and corporate are common types of what financial instrument that gives you a credit or stake in a company? Those would be bonds. Municipal bond. That's a Parks and Recreation joke. We'll see you Thursday. And number 8. I'll name a Billboard charting nerd tune. You give me the artist. Radioactive in 2012 was Imagine Dragons. Starboy in 2016 is The Weeknd. The Scientist in 2002 would be Coldplay. And your last one, Neutron Dance in 1985. Her sisters. All right, one last thing to do before we finalize everything and send you on your lovely Tuesday night. It's time for our last bonus question, a conundrum box to give away to the winner. Do what you do for luck. Here is your question again. It's a mammal and the Top of Day family, or just another name for an embedded spy. They are both moles. Thank you, everybody, so much for playing our weekly quiz here on Twitch. We'll remind you that if you need more quiz fix, we got hat on hat action. I like it. Check out the Hoffer app. That's exclamation point remix, Geeks Who Drink Remix, 3 nights a week on Hoffer. Do check it out. We'd love to see you there. And you might actually win some sweet prizes if you play. There are so many people each and every week who help make this quiz possible. Rather than fail at naming them all, we have a fun little new credit sequence for you. So I hope you enjoyed. Everyone have a wonderful night, and we will see you all next Tuesday or Thursday for our Parks and Recreation quiz right here on Geeks Who Drink here on Twitch. Have a good night, everybody. Cheers, my friends. We'll see you next time.